Following the sharp drop of prices of Ugandan tea on the international market, tea farmers from Kabare District petitioned the Speaker of Parliament Anita Among today over issues of low prices of tea and expensive inputs that have ravaged the industry.
Over the past 1 year, Uganda has consistently experienced very low tea prices on the international market compared to other countries in the region. And the detail of this will come in our petition. This is due to international wars like in Ukraine and Russia, Sudan, among others, which countries are among the leading consumers of Uganda tea.
Among acknowledged that tea has been neglected for so long, and she committed to give the sector more attention in Parliament.
One thing I can promise you is we are going to exhaustively look at that petition, look at your prayers, and handle prayer by prayer.
She noted that, unlike other crops that government has supported, tea has been left behind with no institution to negotiate for better prices.
You've talked about the prices. There is no marketing strategy in place for tea. Completely, it is not there. We don't even have an appropriate regulatory regime which supports the tea, like cotton, coffee.
Grievances of tea farmers center around low prices and absence of a comprehensive policy on tea, among others.
The price per kilogram of green leaf has now currently fallen from 600 shillings to below 100 shillings.
They asked Parliament to bail out the sector with at least 5 billion shillings in form of a stabilization fund, a one-year waiver on corporate statutory obligation and subsidies on inputs.
As a district of Kabarole, we petition government for intervention in revamping the collapsing tea sector to mitigate the unforeseen circumstances.
Recently, New Vision reported that 90 factories had closed business due to a drop in prices of tea, which was occasioned by depreciating quality. In 2021, Uganda exported $24.7 million in tea, making it the 29th largest exporter of tea in the world. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.